quality lives with respect and dignity. We accomplish this by ensuring that veterans and their families can accomplish the full range of benefits available to them. Fighting for the interest of America's injured heroes on Capitol Hill and educating the public about the great sacrifices and needs of veterans transitioning back to civilian life. Providing free professional assistance to veterans and their families and obtaining benefits and services earned through military service and provided by the Department of Veterans Affairs and other agencies of government. Providing outreach concerning its program services to the American public generally and to disabled veterans and their families specifically. Representing the interests of disabled veterans, their families, their widows, spouses, and their orphans before Congress, the White House, and the judicial branch, as well as state and local governments. Extending DA's mission of hope into the communities where their veterans and their families live through a network of state-level department and local chapters. Providing a structure through which disabled veterans can express their compassion for their fellow veteran through a variety of volunteer programs. I now declare this meeting open for the transaction of such business as may rightfully become before it. First, I'd like to thank all of those that are here in person and also like to thank those that are here online. We appreciate everybody being here today. And at this point, I'd ask the Comrade Adjutant, please do the roll call.
Thank you, Comrade Commander. Commander Tom Wendell. Present. Senior Vice Commander Gary Salpini. Present. First Junior Vice Commander Tanya Copert. Present. Second Junior Vice Commander Shamala Kapizi. Absent. Treasurer Kathleen Schultz. Chaplain Reverend John Hoffman is with us online.
Here.
Immediate past Commander Erwin Schultz is excused. DEC Tom Wendell.
Present.
Alternate DEC Shane Learman.
Present.
Officer of the Day, Jim Anders, is online. Sergeant-at-Arms Joe LaHaye is excused. Judge Advocate Erwin Schultz is excused. BPTL Jesse Bendahan is online. Shane Learman, Adjutant, present. Chapter Service Officers, Chris Arrington, Monty Zimmerman, Terry Williams, and Fred Skaggs, I don't believe are here or online, and Assistant Adjutant Jeremy Yost is present. Everyone is accounted for. We do have a quorum, Comrade Commander.
Thank you, Comrade Adjutant. At this time, we will hear our Treasurer's report. Before we do the Treasurer's report, the Adjutant's going to read those members that are present.
Let the record show these are the members that are in the room that have signed in for the meeting this morning. Tom Wendell, Gary Salpini, Shane Learman, Jeremy Yost, G.A. Redding, Kathleen Schultz, and Tanya Colpert. Online members, we have Jim Anders, John Simmons, Reverend John Hoffman, Jesse Bendahan, Randy Reese, and Don H. Guests online include from the Auxiliary Unit 10, Beatrice Stevenson, and Bob Bent.
Thank you, Comrade Adjutant. In reference to our minutes are recorded and videotaped, and they are posted on the website I entertain a motion to accept the minutes as posted on the website. We have a motion by Gary Salpini, a second by G.A. Redding. Any questions on the motion? Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? And the ayes are above the noes. Thank you. At this time, we'll hear our treasurer's report.
Treasurer's report for the period of September 1st through the 30th. We had no income, leaving our balance at $20,517.42. We had one check that came, that went out to Shane Learman for our annual go-to meeting. It was check 4774 for the amount of $348, leaving us with a balance of $20,169.42. I make a motion that you accept my minutes as read, subject to audit.
Jeff Dredgen, Shane Learman, second.
I have a motion and a second. Any questions on the motion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you very much, Comrade Treasurer. At this time, we'll hear our chaplain's report from Chaplain Hoffman online.
Oh, good morning, everyone. Not sure if you can hear me okay.
Yes,
but,
we can.
Some sad news, but sad news that we did receive this week is that from our auxiliary, the adjutant treasurer, Marcy Reed, passed away. A sad note there. Our condolences to our auxiliary members and to Marcy's family as well. On a second note, I received my surgery on Thursday for the tumor that I had. It was malignant. They got clear margins. I need no further treatment, so we're grateful for that. And with that, I see Jim is present online, and we're grateful for his recovery as well. That completes my report.
Thank you very much, Comrade Chaplain, and glad to hear that your surgery went well. We're definitely saddened to hear about the passing of our auxiliary treasurer. And for those that are out there, please keep their families in your prayers. And Jim, continue to recover. Thank you. Comrade Adjutant, any communications?
Yes, we do, Comrade Commander. Thank you. As we discussed at the previous meeting, our State Corporation Commission filing was required for the year, as well as a $25 payment. And I completed it online, and I believe the treasurer sent in the $25 payment. However, we did just receive a statement from the Commonwealth of Virginia State Corporation Commission advising us that they did not receive the payment or the online submission. However, we did receive confirmation online that our submission was accepted, and when I reviewed it, it showed we had a prior balance. However, this is advising us that we have now owe them $35 and we must comply before the December 31st. So what I need to do is verify with the treasurer, because I know she submitted the payment, and we'll have to contact the State Corporation Commission, because our online account shows it was submitted, we had a zero balance, but yet we received this saying that we still owe. And the treasurer just confirmed that the payment was sent, and it was the check brokered?
Yeah. It's on the bank statement.
All right. Oh, yes, it was. It was. That's right. I remember seeing it on there. So we received that, Comrade Commander. I will have to contact the state corporation because it does show a zero balance. It does show the check cleared, and our online account shows it was taken care of. So I will contact them over the course of the next few weeks to get to the bottom of that. We also received notice from the past department commander for the state of Virginia, Lisa Gregory, asking that we have a point of contact from Chapter 10 specific to the Homeless Veterans Committee for the department. And Comrade Commander, we've shared that email, so I want to advise you that they are requesting a specific point of contact from Chapter 10.
Thank you, Comrade Anthony.
And to clarify the roll call from earlier, I would like to recognize that second Junior Vice Commander, Shamala Capizzi, is present and in the room. Correct, Shamala?
Yeah.
There she is. We also received the DAV 2021 Daily Planner and a letter from the National Membership Director. Pretty. And you put stuff in here, like a calendar. Yes. That's why it's a daily planner and calendar. I've received one. I believe Tom has one. If anybody in the room would like it, I will place them over here. Also received a donation just a few days ago from a Dietrich Dennis in Hamburg, Pennsylvania. We received a $100 donation to Disabled American Veterans Chapter 10 and $100 from Barbara Diedrich. There is a note with it that says, this is a donation in memory of James Ladden. Please send a notice to his wife that we're making the donation to DAV Chapter 10. They provided her address. And the note also says, this is a one-time donation to Chapter 10. Please don't send us any other requests. To clarify, we don't request donations from Chapter 10. And I looked through our membership system. I could not verify that Pat Ladden or the Dietrichs are members of Chapter 10. But it was sent directly to us and made out directly to Chapter 10. So we thank them very much. I will turn this over to the treasurer, and we will make sure we send them a letter to the surviving spouse as well as to the Dietrich family and thank them for their donation. We also received a request for transfer. It was done online. We received this from the National Membership Director. And it is in reference to a James Nickel requesting to transfer from South Dakota Chapter Number 3 in Rapid City to Chapter 10. He has recently moved to the area in Falls Church. So we have that. That would require a vote, Comrade Commander. And I believe that is all we have for communications.
Thank you, Comrade Adjutant. In reference to the transfer, we'll go ahead and do the vote now. So in reference to James Nickel transferring from South Dakota to Arlington-Fairfax Chapter 10, I'd entertain a motion to approve the transfer. Got a motion from Gary Salpini. Do I have a second? I have a second from Tanya Copert. And any questions on the motion? Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Thank you. There you go, Comrade Adjutant.
Thank you, Comrade Commander. Comrade Commander, we have another member that have just joined. I want to welcome Bob Whaley.
We'd like to welcome Bob Whaley that just joined us online.
Happy to be back.
Thank you. All right, what do we have next there, Comrade Edge?
Sorry, Comrade Commander, I'm trying to do too much at once. It's almost like if I needed an assistant.
All right, committee reports. BPTO, Jesse Benaham, anything out there?
Good morning. No issues to report today, Comrade Commander. Thank you.
Thank you. Shane, anything for legislative BPTL wise?
Yes, there are a few things I just want to bring up real quick and remind everybody. On the November 3rd election, on the Virginia ballot is question number two. Question number two, if you vote yes, will allow disabled veterans who are 100% permanent and total in the state of Virginia to get property tax exemption on one vehicle per veteran. And the reason I want to make sure everybody's aware of that so they consider voting on this issue is because that issue started here in Chapter 10 several years ago, and we've been forwarding it as a resolution to the Department of Virginia. Department of Virginia has been pushing it a lot. And in the last year, we got it to the, or actually 2 years ago, we got it to the JLC, which is the Joint Leadership Commission in the state of Virginia. It's a group of veterans that are created by the governor to be advisors. They got that issue pushed. Last year, it was approved, but since it's a change to the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia, it requires a vote, and that's why this year it is now on the ballot for November 3rd. You can vote no, but if you, and then veterans won't get that tax break, or you can vote yes, and 100% P&T veterans will get the tax break. Decision is yours. I don't think I need to say anything more. But I do want to say this. It's pretty amazing how an idea started in this chapter, not even by an active member, but somebody who read our newsletters online, contacted us, shared the idea. We've been pushing this idea for 7 or 8 years now, I think, and we got it on the ballot. That is pretty amazing when you think about it. Shows you the legislative process works. Our resolution process works. Our leadership in the Department of Virginia DAV has been pushing this and got it through with the JLC. So this is pretty amazing. Something that's about to become law started here. I'm sorry, but that gets me excited. Anybody else got goosebumps? Yeah. Yes? Good, because it gets me excited. I have never influenced the law before like this. Has anybody else? Exactly. So this is something we should be very proud about and make sure that we're advising everyone, not just veterans, to be aware of the question and what a yes means and what a no means. So it's very exciting. In reference to legislative issues on Capitol Hill, there's really nothing at this point moving because 2 weeks ago, the House went into recess until after the election. The Senate went into recess, came out of recess to hold the hearings on Capitol Hill, but no other committee or action is being done at this time in the Senate. However, next week, there is going to be a hearing in the Senate Veterans Affairs Committee on the issue of VA healthcare, specifically community care and the caregivers program. DAV is writing a statement for the record. That hearing is next week, and if you want to watch the hearing, go to senate.gov. Look for the Veterans Affairs Committee, click on it. They show it live on that page, and that is all I have at this time, Comrade Commander.
Thank you very much there, Comrade Adjutant. I'd also like to welcome Member Nathan Cheney into the room. Nathan, thank you. Good to see you. All right, chapter officer, Service Officer Christine Arrington. I don't believe she's online today. But we do have one of our assistant adjutants. He is the supervisor of our Washington, D.C. office. Jeremy, anything interesting you'd like to tell us right now? Yeah, all right. Nothing at this time. Thank you, Jeremy. Membership, Gary Salpini. All right. One thing I like to note in reference to membership, we did this week receive an email from, who was it from? From the Department of Virginia, giving us the hot list for membership. We did this 2 years ago. We took the hot list and sent out postcards in reference to getting people that are prospective members and getting them to become members. And that, when we did that 2 years ago, that was the first time we had met membership goal in about 5 to 7 years. So that's something we need to look at as a chapter, whether we want to take that hot list and pursue that again this year. So, women veterans, Tanya? Nothing new on women veterans at this point. Next one, Shane?
Yeah, I'm trying to get back there. Sorry.
Anything on social media, Shane?
Why, yes. Chapter 10 social media accounts. Our Twitter account has blown up over the last several weeks. I want to thank Comrade Jim Precuner for taking care of that. Our Facebook, we are continuing to get a lot of hits and posts from a lot of the different things we're posting. And our newsletter that just went out earlier this week was opened and read by over 350 members of Chapter 10. That's a good draw. I know we have 3,000 members, but the fact that we're actively engaging 350 members and being aware of what we do is a very exciting part of our social media and our awareness campaigns. Our website needs to be updated and some construction done, so that will be worked on by me, I'm assuming, over the next few weeks. I was looking for somebody to say, Shane, I'll do it, and that was my mistake. Because I think I'm the only one that has access, so... That's my fault. This is Shane's fault because he's the only one that has access to the website. So blame Shane. It's what I do. So that's what we got going on with social media. We're going to be having some, hopefully, some new things coming out on our YouTube channel. We're getting more hits on there because we're recording all of these meetings as a video, uploading them to our YouTube channel. We're placing them on our website and sharing them in social media as well. And I have an idea I'm just going to throw out there. I know. On most of the major holidays, we always see a lot of videos and things circulating from our members in reference to veterans and what's going on. But one thing we never see videos on is disabled veterans dressed up in costume for Halloween, wishing everybody a happy Halloween. We don't see that, do we? No, we don't, Commander. So I am going to ask every officer of Chapter 10, I'm asking if you would like to record a 30-second to 1-minute video of yourself in costume, wishing veterans happy Halloween and anything else you want to say, please do so. Send that video to me, and we will get them out online for Halloween. And we're looking at doing that for every holiday coming forward. Just keeps our awareness out there. And again, with the pandemic and a lot of veterans not able to get out, it's just another way for us to share more information from ourselves, more awareness to those who probably are still locked down at home. So, officers of Chapter 10, if you want to do it, great. If not, bah humbug on you. We're going to make you dress up as Santa come Christmas. That's all I have, Comrade Commander.
Thank you, Comrade Adjutant. And that's a very interesting idea. And I told him last night when he put it out to me, I said, sure, I'll dress up. I still got my Dalmatian costume, and I'm sure Kathleen has her witchy poo costume, and she can turn me into a dog again. So, so yes, we will have a little bit of fun with this. Hopefully members and people out there will have a little fun. Jim Pecunier, I know you're a person that definitely would dress up for this. So stand by. Fundraising. Hold on, Shane did something.
Oh no, we're good.
All right. Fundraising, nothing new to report at this time. Next one. Kathleen, anything new on budget and financing? Nope. All right. Yeah. Financially, the chapter is doing very well right now. So we appreciate that. Next. Unfinished business. All right, first thing we got coming up is our online information webinar. That's going to be on October 27th at 7 p.m. This was the very first one that we ever did, which was on the 7 methods of service connection. Unfortunately, at that point, we didn't know that we could record everything on GoToMeeting, so that one never got recorded, so we're going to reintroduce that one. Hopefully educate people on the 7 methods of service connection. Our assistant adjutant, Jeremy Yost, is going to be leading it with the help of myself and Comrade Adjutant and possibly Comrade Schultz. So, but we look forward to seeing everybody on October 27th. It will be in our newsletter. We will be sending out the link for that. So stand by, and we hope that everybody learns a little bit from this. Online chapter service training, service officer training. What we're looking at is basically in November, we're going to be doing our chapter officer training. Oh, yeah, I skipped one, didn't I? So CSO, DSO training. What happened was the training actually took place on October 7th. Somehow we missed that specific email. We apologize for that. But talking with NAS Officer Ogdeen from the Roanoke office, he is going to be doing a makeup session on that. So we will get our CSO, our chapter service officers in there for that training. If for some reason that can't happen, we'll work out a arrangement with Oscar like we did a few years ago where, you know, between all the experience we have with service officers in our chapter, you know, we could do our own training. So if we have to, we will, but we're looking at jumping in on his makeup session. Meeting location, something we still need to think about. You know, as you saw last month, you know, when we were here at the Legion, we were down in the small room, and that's a real inconvenience for us, you know, especially when we're trying to do things on social media and get things out. So we definitely need to look at a different location for us. So what I'm asking is, you know, as far as members, you know, go online, talk to places in your neighborhood and see what we can find. I've gone online. I've looked at a few places. I just haven't been able to go and physically look at them yet, but I like to go and physically look at a couple places. So hopefully the next meeting I can go, and before then I can go look at those places, bring you some ideas, hopefully some pictures of the places, and then we can, you know, present a few things to the chapter. But if you have any places that you know of that we could possibly meet, and we understand we're not always going to get it for free like we do here at the Legion, you know, but of course we don't want to pay $500 to meet, but if we, somebody's going to charge $25 or $50, you know, we can handle something like that. But if we can find somewhere that it's going to be free, you know, especially as a nonprofit organization, we definitely want to try that first. So if you have any ideas, you know, please present those to myself and Comrade Adjutant, and we can bring it before the executive committee. So thank you very much on that. Holiday banquet. We voted in the last meeting that we would not be hosting a holiday banquet this year. And we were looking at doing some donations to the DAB COVID Relief Fund or the Disaster Relief Fund. So those are a couple of things that we're looking at doing. And we're also looking at possibly doing a few things online, you know, as far as similar to the Halloween thing, you know, possibly dressing up as Santa Claus, you know, doing a few things for Christmas time. So we'll be taking a look at that as well, possibly doing some online things. So we'll definitely keep everybody advised. If you have any ideas, you know, please feel free to express those ideas to us. Chapter officer training, we're looking at doing that online in November. So we're going to be putting together a program. We will let all the officers know. But like we said last time, it's not just for the officers. You know, if somebody's looking at wanting to learn more about DAB, wanting to learn more about the chapter, maybe you want to be an officer in the future, coming to this training can definitely help and educate you. You know, there's a lot of things about DAB that, you know, the person that walks into a meeting may not know. So Shane does a great job in talking about the history of the DAB. So, you know, right now you're looking at 100 years of service with DAV right now. So, you know, with this being our 100th year, you know, there's a lot of history there. So when we teach our officers about DAV, it's not just about Chapter 10. We're talking about the history of the DAV itself. So just because you're not an officer doesn't mean you can't attend that training. So we will be putting that out, you know, on our newsletter as well. Froze again.
Adapt and overcome.
All right. Winter sports clinic. Like we said in our previous meeting, Shane had talked to National and they did advise us that the $10,000 that we donated last year will roll over to this year. So we still will be a gold level sponsor for the winter sports clinic. Now, last year we voted to reimburse chapter commanders airfare and hotel expenses. I'll let Shane take care of that motion since it involves me.
Thank you. As a gold level sponsor of the winter sports clinic, we get the opportunity to have a representative from Chapter 10 attend the winter sports clinic and be a part of all the festivities and a few of the sponsor level events as well. In the past, we have sent past chapter commander Jim Pecunier. We've sent chapter member G.A. Redding. And last year we voted to send commander Tom Wendell, the guy standing right over here. Wow, I just drew a blank. Yeah, that's what happens when you get hit in the head too many times. So last year we voted to approve to reimburse Tom's airfare and hotel expenses. But as we know, the winter sports clinic this year was canceled. So I would like Chapter 10 to have a representative at the winter sports clinic again in 2021. I'm not sure if it's going to be held yet. I don't believe they made any of those decisions because it's normally in April, March or April every year. But in case we do, I would like to go ahead and make a motion that Chapter 10 reimbursed the airfare and hotel expenses for Commander Tom Wendell to attend as Chapter 10's representative. Do I have a second? We have a second from G.A. Redding. Are there any questions or discussions on the motion? Since I'm not the commander, can I call for a vote, Tom? I can? Thank you. All those in favor signify by aye. Those opposed, no. There you have it. The ayes are above the noes.
You just wanted to say that.
Yes, I did. Been too long.
All right. Well, thank you, everybody. I greatly appreciate that. Hopefully the Winter Sports Clinic does take place again, you know, this coming year. We're, you know, I'm excited to be the representative for this chapter. I've never been to a Winter Sports Clinic. I've been with DAV for 20 years, and I've heard a lot about it. People that have gone have told me that, you know, it's an unbelievable experience. So I would definitely, you know, appreciate the opportunity to represent Chapter 10 at the Winter Sports Clinic. So thank you very much for that. And we did have two other members join us online. So I'd like to welcome Lloyd Haley and Pamela Lewis. Welcome, folks. Before we go, things I forgot to say last night. Reference to old business, one other thing we do need to look at is make sure that we're looking at our storage unit. And one, I went and looked at our storage unit a couple weeks ago. I went in there and we probably use about a quarter of the space in that specific unit. So what I'd like to ask the chapter about is before we actually pay for our new storage unit this coming year, you know, possibly look at contacting the storage unit, see if they do indeed have a smaller unit that we could possibly get versus paying what we're doing for the current unit. Now, with that in mind, you know, we did just have a member that he had a family member that passed away, and he donated a wheelchair, a bed lift, a toilet lift, a few other things that he donated. So those things are currently in our storage unit. You know, if there's a member out there in need, you know, we can definitely try and get those items to them if anybody needs those items. But, you know, based on the amount of room we're actually using in that storage unit, you know, we may be paying too much for, you know, what we're storing. So basically what I'm asking at this point is, you know, that I be able to contact the storage unit, find out they actually do have a smaller one than what we're using. Because when I walked around, it looked like the majority of them were the same size as ours or bigger. So I'm not sure they have any smaller ones. So we would definitely have to ask that. And then we can make a decision before we pay it if we want to downsize or not. So, yes, Nathan.
If they don't have a smaller one, could we, I guess, include in that motion, if they don't have a smaller one, also offer that you, if there's other suggestions of places that have smaller storage.
Yeah, we can definitely look at, you know, looking at other places if they don't have a smaller one. And of course, we got to look at prices, you know. We've been there for a while, so they do, you know, work with us. You know, they normally give us 1 month free. So that's one of the advantages of where we're at. So, but we'll have to look at the whole package and see where we're at. But all we really don't need a motion, I guess. All I'm going to say is that before the next meeting, I'm going to do some more investigating. I'm going to talk to the storage unit. And then before we actually make the decision to pay it this year, that we come back in, we vote as to how we want to proceed. So, yeah, it's due on December 1st. So. So what the treasurer said is it's due in December, and last year it was $1,800, and they did not give us a free month last year, but they did the year before that. So just to keep those things in mind, and we'll look at that as we move forward. So any questions or comments on that? Hearing none, thank you very much. New business. DAV 5K. I'll give this one to Shane. Oh, okay. Well, I'll give it to Jeremy, because he's the one that, Shane and Jeremy researched this online. I didn't look at it. Come on up, Jeremy.
So the DAV 5K is going to be going on between November 7th to 11th. Of next month. It is a virtual 5K. So if you get your information in before October 28th, you can get all your stuff sent to you before the event. So you can go online at dav5k.org and look that information up. But you can do it all virtually. You can do it as a group, as long as you're keeping social distancing, or you can do it yourself. You just have to show that you started it and how you're going to complete that. And then that can go online, and your score can also go online on how well you did.
Thank you very much, Jeremy. And that's something to look at. You know, DAV, you know, especially Chapter 10, you know, we've gone down when the 5K took place down in, Portsmouth.
Newport
News is where it was. Yeah, there you go. So we used to go down and to Newport News when they were hosting the 5K here in Virginia. Chapter 10 had its own team, and you know, many of us have gone and walked it and raised funds for that. So, you know, if you want to do it online, you know, definitely take a look at this, and we can definitely help support you any way we can.
Yeah, the email address for the website is dav5k.org.
And the website is dav5k.org. And that will be in our after action report as well. All right, veterans and families in need. As those of you that attended our Christmas banquet last year, you saw that we invited four families from within our chapter area. I contacted the county and received names of veterans that were in need. So we invited four families to our banquet last year, and those four families were very appreciative of being invited. And we also gave them gift cards to be able to get food for their families during the holiday. So we're looking at doing something similar to that this year. Of course, we're not going to be hosting the banquet, but one of the things that we're looking at, if I get the approval from the chapter to move forward, is I will contact the county this week. And what I'd like to do is sponsor five families. And with that, we want to do a couple things with them. We want to start it earlier this year, not just doing it at Christmas. We'd like to start out at Thanksgiving. So we'd like to start out at Thanksgiving, giving them, you know, a gift card or food for their Thanksgiving meal, but then turn around after Thanksgiving, talk to the families and find out if, as far as themselves, the parents, their children, what types of needs they have for Christmas. You know, a couple gifts, you know, they can turn around and give us a list of a couple items for each individual in the family. And last night, myself, Shane, and Jeremy were talking, and we thought about a virtual giving tree, similar to what you see at the malls where you have people that go up and you pick an angel off the tree or whatever it may be, and it has a gift. So we're looking at doing something like that for our members to be able to give during the holiday season. Now, this isn't something that's mandatory for anybody. This is just something that we feel that we're gifted, that we can be able to reach out to some of our fellow veterans that are in need during the holiday season and make sure that them and their families, you know, aren't suffering, especially this year with COVID-19. A lot of people are out of work this year, or maybe they're working but not getting, you know, what they normally would. So there's a lot of need out there this year. So we'd like to be able to sponsor some families this year, hopefully do the virtual giving tree. And we're going to come up with some ideas as far as that. Shane and I looked at a couple programs online last night, and we think we have one that may work. That's a free program where we can actually do it. So, you know, this is something we really want to try and help out our community and help our veterans within our community. So I hope everybody will be on board. But before we move there, you got something to say? Shane wants to say something as well.
Yeah, just to clarify what this is and what it isn't, we are not asking for donations online to Chapter 10. That's not what this would be. What it would be is, as Tom described, there would be a gift, a list of gifts for specific individuals. Then anybody, not Chapter 10, but then anybody could purchase that gift for that veteran, disabled veteran in their family. And we would have it sent to a collection site. Then before Christmas, I believe we have a commitment from Chapter 10 Santa Claus to go to each of the houses to deliver the gifts. So this would just be a donation, a purchase of the gift by a chapter member. There's no money being donated, so it's not an online fundraising campaign. I just want to make sure we clarify what it isn't. What it is it just lets any member who wants to purchase a gift for a veteran's family in need, they could do so and then have it mailed to a specific location. Since Chapter 10 doesn't have a building, it would probably either be Tom's or my house. Is probably where it would end up if we decide to do this. Again, this is just us thinking. We haven't decided yet because we haven't gotten the list of families and those in need. But I think it's a great idea of sharing and helping disabled veterans and their families, especially right now. So I want to thank Tom. This was his idea, and it just goes to show the compassion Tom always shows as our leader in Chapter 10. Thank you.
Thank you, Comrade Adjutant, for those comments and for always making sure that our members are clear of what this is not, because we are not allowed to fundraise online. So we want to make sure that is clear to everybody. Now, we will have to look at, you know, setting a dollar amount for whatever gift card or food items that we will give to these people, you know, but what I'm looking at right now is I like to entertain a motion to at least start moving forward, allow me to contact the counties, see if we can get names, get started on this, and then we can turn around. We would have time at the next meeting to set the exact dollar amount, you know, or we could set it today, you know, but one thing we need to look at is, I think last year the gift cards we gave at Christmas time was $200 for each family, $100. So, you know, we could look at, you know, be looking at $200 at Thanksgiving, $200 at Christmas, you know, if everybody felt comfortable with that, or if you felt comfortable with something less. So, okay, so we have a motion from Mr. Cheney in reference to allowing me to go ahead and contact the counties, try and get names of those in need, and then coming back for the exact dollar amount at our November meeting. So I have a motion. Do I have a second?
I'll second that.
A second from Jeremy Yost. Any questions on the motion?
Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you very much, folks. And I did see that we have our National Executive Director from Washington, D.C. online, Mr. Reese. Do you have any comments for the chapter?
I don't have anything, Tom. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much for attending, Randy. All right. Anything for good of the order? Anything new, Shane? All right. Nothing online for good of the order? All right. Next. Yeah, we'll do the same. All rise. Comrades, at this time, one moment of silence will be devoted in honor to our departed comrades. May they rest in peace. Comrades, remain standing. Give honors to the flag. Hand salute. Two. Comrade Chaplain, will you lead us in our closing prayer?
Let us pray. May the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God. And now unto the eternal, all-wise creator of the universe, preserver of our nation, be the honor and glory forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Comrade Chaplain. Comrades, the purpose Amen. Of the gathering has been accomplished. Before we close, let us always be mindful of the principles for which this organization stands. Comradeship, friendship, loyalty to principle, and to our comrades, and devotion to our cause. And this meeting is now adjourned. Thank you all for coming online, and thank you for those that are present in the room. Hope to see you next month. Thank you.
Thank you, Jim, John, Beatrice, Bob, Pam.
Thanks, everybody.
Boyd, thank you for all joining us this morning.
Thank you. Aerosol.
I know.